yelling and, you know, all of that stuff. But he's kind of giving me a cold shoulder, like I haven't heard from him, and I'm wondering what's going on. And just so you guys know, like, I do this kind of, like, weird thing when I first go out on dates with people. I basically had them meet my friends for the first couple days because I get just creeped out by meeting people, strangers that I don't know, and my friends kind of give me the okay, and once they know the guy a little bit, like, and they can kind of give me, like, their opinion, I feel good about it, and so he was totally good with it, and so I don't think that was a problem, but I haven't heard from him.
I think he was just being nice to you because you don't want to come out and say, like, just kind of awkward.
Did that happen for all three dates that your friends came out to?
Yeah.
Okay, that's weird.
That's much.
Yeah, why wouldn't you want to spend any alone time with him?
I just, you know, the first 2 days, and nowadays it's like Instagram and people like hitting you up on there and messaging you and being like, hey, I'd love to pick you up. Like, it's just creepy. And so I had to make sure that he was cool. And I mean, listen, these people have known me for so long. Like, my friends are so close to me. And I, you know, it helps. Usually it really helps, like, when this happens. So okay. I'm surprised.
She says it helps. Yeah, she's calling us on the second date.
Update. Right.
All right. Well, you know what? We'll call him next. Maybe that's not it.
Okay.
Hang on. Second date update on the 10th.
I'm gonna catch you, really, while she push up against me.
The new Hot 96.9.
All right, so we just spoke to Laura. She does this weird thing when she goes... Well, it's... I shouldn't say it's a weird thing. When she goes on a date with someone, she invites her friends. That, you know what? For a first date, I don't think that's that weird. But she did it with this dude, Johnny. Not once, not twice, but three times.
Right.
We're calling him for another date. Is it going to be just with you and him? Or is it you... Because we ain't going to pay for you and your whole damn crew if he says yes. Even though our second date budget is still at about $50,000 because we've only spent like $10 on it. Still. Okay, so hang on. We're going to call him now.
Hello?
Hi. Can we speak to a Johnny, please?
Yeah, this is Johnny.
Hi, Johnny. This is, it's Romero, Pebbles, Melissa, and Wiggy. There's four of us on the phone. We're calling from Hot 96.9, the radio station.
What, really?
Yeah, so it's the Get Up crew. And we're calling you because somebody contacted us because they're trying to get in contact with you. And it's a good thing. It's not like you don't owe anybody money or anything like that. It's a girl that wants to take you out on a dinner, and we're willing to pay for it.
Yeah.
You still listening?
Okay. I'm here. All right. This is just weird. Yeah. Okay.
So the date would be for just you and her, and that's going to be different because you've gone out with this girl before, except that you've gone out with her and her friends. Her name is Laura. Remember Laura?
Yeah, I remember Laura for sure. I'm good, man.
Well,
but
she said, because she did tell us about your other dates, she said that this date could just be you and her, just you two. For the first time ever.
Nah, I'm good, man.
Was it her friends?
Her friends are nice. They just
you can say it. It's her friends.
Yeah, just say it. You don't have to like all her friends. I don't like all my wife's friends.
It's her friends. But here's the thing: it's not just that they're her friends; it's that all of her friends are guys, and she is all of them at one point.
You're lying.
And you know this because
damn.
Well, because I spent three nights with them, essentially.
Right.
So and they all said this.
He was engaged to one of them 10 years ago.
Jesus.
All right, so there's one.
Okay.
All right? One of the other guys is like. Still, like, totally into it, giving me stink eyes all night like that. And then another guy kept telling me, like, how good she was in bed and shit, you know, like, different sexual. I'm like, what the this is not something, I mean, like, you know, like, I don't want to get involved in all that, like, weird, I don't know, incestual shit with that group.
So, wait, you're going out with her and three of her ex-boyfriends?
No, I'm going out with her and five, dude. Five ex-boyfriends. It's ridiculous.
Can I come in here right now?
Okay, well, hold on. This is perfect. Johnny, Laura's on the phone. She heard what you just said.
Johnny, like, seriously right now?
Really?
Like, it's not even that big of a deal. Like, just man.
What do you mean, seriously? How is it not a big deal? Literally, all of these guys you have been with.
But if you have been listening, you would actually get some insight on who I am because they know me so well.
I think they know you a little bit too well, honestly.
Laura, let me interject here. The rules are when you're gonna bring. I didn't know. I was assuming they were all girls. That's
right.
Me being naive.
I think
naive.
We all did. Right. Yeah.
But the rules are: if you're gonna bring a male friend in that group of friends, he either has to be the boyfriend of one of your girlfriends who's also in that group of friends, or he has to be your gay male friend.
Right.
You can't have one ex-boyfriend, let alone five of them.
You guys, like, these guys should know everything about me. Like, I just feel like our friendships are even stronger with these guys. Like, because we used to date. You know what I mean? Like, because we have that history. Because we see each other at our best and our worst. Like, you know what I mean? Like, we picked each other up off the ground, and that's amazing. And Johnny just was down for that, that's fine.
Well, no, it's weird. It's too weird to me. I can't deal with this. And to me, every time we go out, it's just be like, no. Can you imagine? No.
Right, and then you got to think about, even when you don't go out like that, like, these guys are still her good friend. All it takes is one night of a couple glasses of wine and some crying on the shoulder, and next thing you know, she's getting tossed around like a damn frisbee.
and if it doesn't work out, maybe you could slide into that group of friends.
They weren't that cool, man. Trust me.
So is that a no to another date?
That is a definite no.
You know what? It's cool. Like most of them were like kind of hot and cold with you anyway. And Steve actually said you were kind of like annoying. You had like this annoying streak. So, and Steve is a good judge of character. So, I mean, it's cool.
Steve is still trying to get in the pants. Damn.
The second date update on the 10th. Weekday mornings at 6:30.